Good day, ladies and gents, and welcome back to another episode of Beginner's Guide Anno 1800. I'm Trigger08. This is episode 4. Where we left off last time, we made it to the new world, and we're going to hit that up as much as we can today and show you guys how that works out. I just want to touch a little bit on Asgard. Off camera, I did a little experiment producing a lot more soap so we could sell it later on and make more profits. I do not recommend what I did. It really decreased our workforce, and as a result, I had to make more houses, more workforce, and then it decreased the hell of our fish, our schnapps, and our work clothes, and our economy was about to crash. But luckily, if you're going to do that, you have to be on your toes and really lay down some buildings and start slapping down some worker clothes and some schnapps and then some more houses. And it's really frustrating, but in the end it works. But it is a waste of workforce. The only reason why I'm doing it is so when we're in the new world there, I'm going to max this out to 250 hopefully. And then we can start selling that and make a lot of profit. We've already made quite a bit of profit from our beer production. I did get that up and running off camera. So all I did was get our wheat fields going. I got our malt fields, our malt house going. And then I am transporting, as you guys seen, the hops. So there is lots of hops going on in here. So our island's producing lots. So that's good, our second island. But yeah, so as this is kicking off, we're not making much money, so when we work in the new world, we will decrease our profits, but hopefully it'll kick up again once we get going. But yeah, so let's just leave Asgard as it is, and let's hop back into the new world. Okay, so here we are. This is where we left off last time. So we needed wood. We're all maxed out on wood, so now we can make more peeps. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go. So we'll lay down some more blueprinting for houses. So those are always good to have. So go ahead and do that. Especially if you're late waiting for resources or you got nothing on your plate to do at the moment, just blueprint everything. And you don't have to worry about it later on. Just hover, highlight, upgrade, and everything shall be built. Okay, so wrap the road around there. We'll leave these corner pieces for some nice little add-ons that we have to add on later on. Build these up. Okay, nice. So our first production that we need, well, it was timber. We got that going. Now it's going to be this fried banana plantation stuff. So we're going to have to get that going. So we need fish oil. We need a plantation for those, and then we need fried kitchen. So let's go ahead and find a nice little area for that. For fish oil, you need it on the edge of like the beach. So it's kind of like the fish huts in the old world. So let's go ahead. We'll lay down. Well, first we should go over how long it'll take. So it'll take 30 seconds for one fish oil. 30 seconds for the plantation to produce one banana or whatever, plantain, if that's how you properly say it, and then 30 seconds. So you just need one for one. So we're going to do two, so we don't have to worry about it. Later on down the road, we'll just produce two right away. So we'll get a nice little road going here. Everything's connected.
I hereby sentence you to not fail. How did you manage to wriggle out of it?
Then we'll connect it to this road here. Bridges do cost quite a bit of wood, so make sure you have enough wood for that. There we go. Actually, I have a better idea for this layout. Bear with me. Leave that road. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay these both down right beside each other. So that fish is gonna go, that fish oil is gonna go directly into the kitchen. Then I'm gonna have the warehouse right here. Then we're gonna have a little road connecting to this main road, like so. And then we're gonna have these plantations connected directly to the kitchen as well. So if it has like potatoes or sugar cane or
a new milestone.
Anything farming, you really want to make sure if you click on it, and make sure if there's actually tiles you have to lay down with it, make sure you just don't build it or it won't work. So go ahead, lay down your tiles. Take up as much space as you want or lay it out as nicely as you want. You can make them perfectly grid, or I like to cover as much ground as I can in the new world, because eventually you're going to need a lot of fields of different resources. So keep that in mind as well. So we'll go this one over here.
Grass is greener on the other side.
We'll get rid
of
him.
Not worth the time.
There we go. So this should work. We just gotta upgrade it now. So let's go ahead, hit that warehouse, hit the fish oils, the farms, and then the kitchens. There we go. So that's gonna do its thing. I'm gonna check out this fire as we're recording. And okay, the marketplace is on fire. Let's go ahead and mobilize these guys. Go to our second island. I believe there's another fire going on over here.
The fire has been vanquished.
Oh, that was easy. Too easy.
The fire, has been vanquished.
Okay. So that was easy. Alright, so our farms are kicking off. That's pretty good. We did unlock more things to build. So we got rum. Then we got more. We can make sails, cotton, to make a cotton mill. That is very important for the old world. So we're going to hit that up right away too. But for now, we're going to have to make more houses. Because the rum production is going to take quite a bit of peeps to make that. Like 30 per one rum distillery, and we're going to make a lot of this. I want to mass produce a lot of rum. But for now, we're going to need a fire station for our new little village that we got going on. So let's go ahead and build that up. We'll fill in the gap with some houses, like so. Build those up. And eventually we'll get the church and police station on the first tier in the new world, so that'll be helpful. We're kind of running out of room on the wings, so let's go ahead and just build up like this. Build you guys.
And I still have a few stories how it used to be.
It should kick off and fill up right away, or eventually, so let's check that out. Producing any? Oh, we got one. There we go. So we should get more workers for that as well. So what we're going to need to do is find a nice location. This island's really small. It's kind of frustrating, but we'll make it work. So I want to keep this area for the consumer goods. Well, we won't count rum for that. Rum's going to be directly for the new world. Or the old world, sorry. So we're going to make some rum over here. This is a nice little area. Let's get rid of this jungle. There we go. So what we're going to need is... So it does require wood in order to make the rum. So 15 seconds for one wood, 30 seconds for rum, 30 seconds for sugarcane. So we can make two for one lumberjack hut. So we'll lay that out. So let's see how many tiles this takes up. Let's start with that. 128, so that's quite a bit. We won't worry about these oil springs. We'll gather oil from our other islands. So 1, 2, 3, 4. See if we can fit 4 of them over here. Oop, that guy's already built up. What I'll do actually is delete this and try and play around with it as much as I can. I'll try and play around with this, guys, and lay down as see if I could puzzle this properly, and I'll see you guys on the flip side. Alright, welcome back, guys. So I got this awful mess going on here on our beautiful little island. It is what it is, and for you beginners, don't worry about making awful messes. As long as you get the basics of the game, you're making profit, you're getting up on the tiers, and you max out on the tiers, and you actually get somewhere in the game, don't worry about making it pretty. Once you're actually a millionaire in the game, that's when I start worrying about making it pretty. Or if you're really used to the game, you know what you're doing, and then make it pretty. But for now, we're just going to be, make a mess and go from there. So we're going to make up all of our little farms here. So we got all six going. We don't have our distilleries going. See how massive these are? They take up a lot of room. We still have to add one more to keep up with production. So let's go ahead and add one over here. And then we'll add a warehouse for it. And then we're going to need more lumber. So we're going to need one, two, and then three. So we're going to need three lumberjack huts. So we're going to need room for those as well. So can we add one over here? We can. Take off blueprint mode because I like to lay these down without blueprint mode on. So let's go ahead, lay that down. And we'll lay this one down. So we need three, eh? And we're going to need to lay one over here. There we go. So we're going to add roads to this. It's not quite 100%, but she'll do.
Is out of control.
There we go. And then can you connect? Yeah, I could use that warehouse. So we'll see if this layout works. Probably won't. Might have some backlog going on there, but whatever. Such is life. I did hear that we do have a workforce shortage, so we'll check that out after the newspaper here. I'll slap down some fake news here, get rid of all these negatives.
Wonderful idea.
Boom, there we go. Too easy. Alright, so we got a huge fire that took out quite a bit of residence houses.
You gained an influence bonus.
These damn fires, I tell you, keep you on your toes. So we are losing work, farmers. Is it because we're out of resources on something? Yeah, look at that. We dropped really low on worker clothes, so we have to get those back up and running. Alright, so we're going to have to build more of those, and it takes up more residents, and you're going to need to build more houses. So, where should we build it? Let's just build one right here. We got to lay this down as quick as we can. Quick as a bunny. So let's go ahead, lay that down. We're going to need more schnapps as well, so let's add another distillery there. Add some farm. Don't need a road in between there. Save the money. Okay, so we'll lay down some farm fields there. Stretch this out as much as we can. There we go. Same with this. Don't need the road there. So go ahead like that. Place the farm there. Boom, boom. This is going to take a couple hundred residents to build these up. Well, that's okay. We'll build more houses to replace those. We'll build them over here. We got lots of room here. Slap down some houses here. The fire is a little annoying, so it doesn't really tell me how much residence I have available or not. So let's fast forward the game here. Come on, put out that fire. They can't put out the fire there. Do we have another fire station kicking around? I don't think so. What about this one? Can't reach that one house. That's annoying.
The fire left ruins behind.
Let's go ahead, build one here. We could upgrade these guys again.
Your city has grown more beautiful.
Then we'll see if our population grows and see if our consumer goods stay stable somewhat. We need that back up and running. Fish is good, so that's good. We don't have to worry about that. Soap's going down quite a bit. That's weird. Probably because of our trade route. Yeah, so maybe if I put the brakes on that and let the soap build up while we're playing in the new world, that would help out. So all you need to do is click on a ship, click on pause, and they'll stop doing what they're doing, and you don't have to delete the route. So just click on pause and the ship will stop doing its thing for now. Okay, so residence is slowly going up. We got 9. These guys need to build back up as well. Clothes is getting there. I don't know if it's good enough. Schnapps, not really. There we go. We're back. Everything's getting stable.
Plenty to get stuck into.
So just remember, if you get like this and you're losing lots of economy and stuff like that, just don't panic. Everything will go back to normal. As long as you build those houses up and build those extra fields that you need to keep everything stable in the consumer goods, and keep an eye on it. The best way is to fast forward it and just watch it grow and see if your population will actually increase. Right now it's still decreased, so we'll add 5-6 more houses. Then we'll be +6 or +10, hopefully. And then that'll help out. But remember, if you build too many houses, then you'll lose more resources. So you gotta keep it in a balance. You gotta balance it out. Making lots of beer here. Don't need that much beer. We're not that much of alcoholics. Let's go ahead and drop that down to 60. And we are transporting schnapps to our other island too, so we could put the brakes on that. What we'll do is, wrong tab. We'll actually go in our tab here and just delete that. And then we'll let our schnapps build up on our main island. So we don't have to worry about that. Our worker clothes is going up. See, it was bouncing between 1 and 2. Now it's bouncing. See, it's slowly going up. So that's good. That should stay stable. Should be good there. Soaps is rising high. That's awesome. We want that high. We want that full. So yeah. Another thing is, we have lots of resources, lots of money, so we could do it. Worker tab. We didn't touch anything about the harbor. This is really useful. I like to save it till I have enough money to build on it. But yeah, you could upgrade your warehouse and it could store more goods, but that's not satisfying enough. I want more goods. I want this freaking island to like be producing a lot of goods and hoard it all and then sell it all. So you could add these things, which is little warehouses on the ocean. So go ahead, lay down as many as you want. So I'm gonna lay down 6 here. Does take up quite a bit of bricks, 10 bricks, 10 wood. Just click, hover, highlight, boom. Now we got these lovely warehouses that are allowing us to store way more goods. Look at that, 550. So if we have 550 soap, imagine that the freaking the sell cost for that. The freaking, we'll make lots of money with that. And then the harbor acts like the town hall, so you could add items in there, and it adds awesome benefits for your harbor. So loading time, resources being stored, like all kinds of stuff. It's unlimited things that you could add, so it's really neat. So yeah, definitely hit that up when you have a time to hit that up. And another thing is brick roads. This is something that if you have money and lots of bricks, hit those up. This is what saves a lot of production time too. So the roads actually transfer goods faster to warehouses. So there's a huge benefit for that. Improves street conditions and allows for faster transportation of goods. So when you can, hit this up, and it looks a lot nicer than dirt roads. So let's go ahead, lay down some brick roads here and watch our goods fly. Down the streets. There we go. Brick roads for everyone. It's nice when you're in the new world and you're just playing around with getting that settlement going. Then all of your resources in this world just builds up, like the bricks and wood and everything. And you don't have to worry about waiting for that kind of stuff. So like, look, we're using up quite a bit of bricks, but it's worth it. So we got all these brick roads going. Resources are going to be flowing a lot quicker, filling up those warehouses. 500 out of 550 we could store of each resource now. This is what the game's all about. And then you could add it in your city as well. I like to. Makes everything look pretty. You don't need to. It could be a waste, but Like this little farming community over here, it's just farmer houses. Could have just left a dirt road. Make it look more realistic. But why not? Use the bricks. Spend the money. We could afford it. Almost done here. There we go. So all the bricks that we could do, and we did mostly all of our production area, so that's good. Let's check this out again. Yep, that's going up, so that's good. Sausages are going down. What am I storing? I'm storing 40, so we're at 47, so it's probably because you're selling them. Because we do have the sell tab on, so anything over 40 is being sold. Everything else is boosting up, that's good. Yeah, so I feel like I'm safe to go back to the new world and play around more in there. So let's go ahead and do that. We have lots of wood now in here, and we're maxed out on Sugar King, so that's good. Hopefully we will be on wood as well. So let's build these up. So we almost had enough residents for this. That's okay, we can make more. Damn cliff is in the way, so I can't add a house right there. That's alright. And we got a quest.
Take it before I change my mind.
Accept that gift.
Bring back the good old time. Help the old man with a hat, por favor.
Oh no, there's crocodiles in town, so we have to go and collect all 5 crocodiles. Just zoom in town if you're trying to look for them, or if you want to figure out exactly where they are, just click on the little tab here. And it explains it a lot more in detail. But I've done it a million times, so I know where they are. There's one there. They're really camouflaged too. There we go. A nice item there. So that's equipped in trade union. So productivity plus 12. And you're like, oh no, I didn't get a chance to read all that. To find your items, just click on your trade and post. Click on the items tab, and that's where they're all stored. So you don't have to worry. So affects Sugar King plantation, so that's awesome. We have that going, and tobacco plantation and corn farm. So we could add this and see the effects of that. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm not sure if we need bricks. We need bricks for this, but we do have enough bricks. So the thing is, you want it to be covered. See the blue ring and how those buildings are in the blue ring and they're highlighted? You want that. So if it's over here, it's not going to affect those plantations like we want to. So we're going to have to make room with these fields over here. Luckily, we don't have to move too much around. So we'll delete this field. We'll add that there. And then we'll boost up this field again. Let's fill it up in here. And then we'll... It is built. Good. There we go. Now we could add an item in here. Let's go ahead and throw that down. And see where it's really highlighted. So it's just showing all the buildings that item's activated on. So it's all of these. So the productivity is actually going up pretty high. And we're making lots of sugarcane now. Yeah. So that's good to know. So we got sugarcane going. How much are we looking at right now? We got 7 rum. Barrels of rum. So that's good. How's our logs doing? We gotta keep an eye on that. It's going down, but it's probably because it's being turned into timber and into sugar cane rum barrels, so that's good. We can't upgrade that yet. Would be nice. But we need to add more things. So we got the church unlocked. So this is a nice little chapel you could add to your nice little settlement. We'll go ahead and stop you down right about there. And we'll add a little road to you. And then we got the police station. Gotta keep everyone in line. So let's go ahead and add that right there. Everything's green, highlighted, perfect. And we'll add the road. Then we'll add... Let's stretch out the road a little bit. I'll add a little one tall gap around this so I could add ornaments later on down the road. There we go. So that looks pretty. So we got all those. What else do we need? So, to get to the next tier in the new world, we need ponchos. So we need to start building up ponchos, but we should probably get our workforce going up a little bit more before we do that. So let's go ahead, lay down some more houses here, fill in this area. Don't forget your roads. There we go. So we got more houses there that'll build up. And now we're ready to build the ponchos. Alright. So let's get rid of some of this jungle here. It's hard to see with all this jungle in the way. So what we're going to do is go in blueprint mode. Lay down this warehouse. Wrap this bad boy around there. Then we're going to need this poncho. It's kind of like the knitter frameworks. It's like worker clothes. So it takes 30 seconds for the wool and 30 seconds to make a poncho. So we'll just add two for now. Add you and you there. Then you will be added. Yeah, right there is fine. One, two, three, and then four. So instead of three, like the cheap field, it takes four tiles. So you gotta keep that in mind. Make sure you have enough room for all those tiles. Let's go one, two, three, and then four. Jam it all in there, why not? Then we'll fill this little gap up with road. There we go, build that up. Build you guys up, we're out of wood. So let's fast forward that a little bit. Get that wood back.
I'm breaking.
Yes, yes, yes. Boom, and then come on, wood. Almost there. How much wood does it take? 10? 6. Should be there. There we go. Alright, so now we're making ponchos. And once that's going, we should be in the next tier. Got quite a few houses. That's awesome. Our little village has grown in the new world. It's hard to make a nice, perfect village in the new world, because like so many rivers run through it, and you need so many bridges, and the islands are just weirdly laid out. Like, look at all these mountains take up so much room on this island. So yeah, like jam everything together. But Sugar King is going good. We're at 48 barrels of rum, so that's good. Just gotta
Muchas gracias.
Tap into those ponchos. They're slowly going up. And then, yeah, then we could upgrade them. So we'll let that load and do its thing. And then once we're back, we'll go ahead and upgrade them. And welcome back, guys. So there we go. We are 10 out of 10. So let's go ahead and upgrade these houses and get to the next tier of the new world. Go ahead, highlight this. Boom.
A new milestone.
Look at these nice, beautiful, detailed houses. God, I love this game. So there we go. As everything in this game, once you upgrade it, it has new tiers and new things to build. So first things first, just like the worker class, is bricks. We're going to need bricks to get our civilization going even further in the new world. So let's go ahead, find a clay pit, just like in the old world. I'm going to transfer this onto my toolbar. It's really helpful to use this toolbar. There's also this toolbar here. If you hold right click, you have a nice, beautiful toolbar here. I just find it very easy just to click on the toolbar there, but if you need it, it's there. You could also shrink down your toolbar, so if you want to get some cool screenshots, you could also shrink that too. You could also do that. But for now, we'll just keep it up and go with the flow. Alright, so first things first. Clay pit. Warehouse. Brick factories. This brick factory is going to be right in the middle of the town. How lovely is that? Okay, so we're going to need some roads around this bad boy. It's a weird road, but she'll do. I'll just get rid of that, actually. We don't need that road right there. Maybe we could fit some houses in there. Yeah, we'll put a strip of houses right there. There we go. Upgrade those. Boom, boom. Then we're going to have to upgrade these. Let's go ahead and do that. We're out of wood to make the brick factories, but that's okay. That'll build up. And we're out of workforce, so we're going to need more workforce. So let's go ahead and upgrade more houses. Upgrade you, out of wood, upgrade you, out of wood. Let's fast forward the game. And we are making bank right now because of fake news. So off camera, there was fake news, or the newspaper came up and I slapped down 15% of income, and look how much money we're making now. We're just flying through this game. It's awesome. So let's go ahead, upgrade these. And then we're going to upgrade our brick factories. And once more, once we get more wood, I believe it takes 10 wood? 8 wood. Getting there. Here we go. And then we're going to need more houses. We'll push play on that.
Spare a thought for us.
Go away. Don't want you. No refugees on my island. Almost there. There we go. Okay, next things next is the tortilla. So we're going to need cattle farm and corn farm, and then it makes the burritos. Okay, so we go back all the way to our food production area, which is a lovely little area over here. We'll stretch our road through here so we could build on this side. We'll slap down a warehouse, and then 30 seconds, a minute, and a minute. So we're going to just need two of these. Let's go ahead and lay you there, and we'll lay another one right there, and we'll slap a road right around here. So I want my cattle farms to be a little bit closer. It takes 6 tiles, so let's see if we can fit this in here. If not, that's okay. We'll find another little spot for it. So that's 3, halfway there. Flip you around and flip you around. There we go. Oh, that's only 5. One more. There we go. We'll do the same over here. Boom. And then we'll go 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we're going to need 2 more. Kind of running out of room here. Go ahead, delete that. See, can we fit 2 in this little spot here? I don't know. This is going to be a really weird layout. Let's put 1 there, and then we'll put 1 right across. There we go.
We're always looking to those we can trust.
I don't want to do missions right now. I'm trying to help others play the game. Without you. There we go, that's 6 tiles there, and then we'll do the same here. We can block off the road there. We don't need the road to go fully through. Then we'll add you there, and then there, and then that's it, 6. Okay, cool. So we'll add the road through here, make a little roundabout right here. Cool, looks good to me. And then we're going to need 2 corn farms, so we'll make it separately. We don't have much room on this island, so we have to use what we got. So let's go ahead, lay down 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. And it takes up 168 tiles. That's a lot of freaking tiles. These darn farms on the New World take up a lot. So that's 168 there. And we're gonna do the same here. Make 1. We gotta fit as much as we can in this area. Rid of this jungle. Can't see what I'm doing. Okay, we're only at 75. So we're gonna wrap this around here. Fill in this area. Sorry, clay pit. We will not be able to use you. That's okay. So we're gonna need more over here. Can we fit? Okay, we can fit another row through there, hopefully. Like so. And then fill that in. Look at that, it's taking up this whole area just for corn. Some more here. There we go. Woo! Almost filled up this whole area, so we got wasted space here, but we could live with that. Nothing's perfect in life. Okay, so now we're gonna need more workers before we build up that farm. We need workforce. Workforce. Alright, so we're going to build up some blueprint houses here. Make sure everything fits nicely. Don't want to go too far because the marketplace can only reach so far. You want to be efficient as possible. So that's a good spot there to end that. And go there. We'll wrap the road around here. I think it looks somewhat legit. Be a gap there with that road, but that's okay. Let's go ahead and build that house up.
A competitor's island is under siege.
Oh no. Build those up, and then we're going to have to build some more roads around here. So we'll go like this, and then like this, and then we'll build that up. And then once the workforce gets enough up there, then we'll come back and we'll build up those farms. So we'll take a little break and let that build up. Welcome back, guys. Okay, our workforce is up there, getting there, so we could go ahead and build these ponchos. So let's go ahead and start with the cornfields here. Or not ponchos, sorry, the tortillas. Go ahead, upgrade all these beautiful farms. Got our cattle farms next, where we're out of wood. That always happens when I try and do something, explain something to you guys, something bad happens. But no worries, I got another idea. So another thing, once we get enough people going, is upgrading our warehouse. So we need 10 wood for that. And then we could add those harbor warehouses as well, which will add more goods because we're ready to start transporting rum. I like to hit like a 100 mark for rum so I could transport 100 at a time. It does take a lot of time to travel between the new world and the old world. So you got to keep that in mind, how much you're transporting at a time. But yeah, so let's go slap down some more blueprint here. Why not? And then upgrade some houses so we can unlock that new harbor area. There we go. We unlocked it. So there we go. So if we click on that, oh, it's not in there. It's on the first tier. Withstood an attack. We didn't have to upgrade that, but whatever. We did. So we could add some of these. We'll add 6 again. I think it takes a lot more brick. Nope. Same amount. I lied. So let's go ahead, build 2 of those up. Now we could actually produce more rum. And we could get this clipper ready to start transporting all those amazing, all the rum. Why is the rum always gone? Back to the old world, and we'll get that going. We're ready to build our cattle farms once we get wood. So that's good. We're making bank. So while we're waiting for wood, why not make things look pretty? So I keep saying, oh yeah, I'll add ornaments in there, I'll fill in those gaps and stuff, but I haven't really done that yet in this series. So we're going to do that, and I'll show you what I mean. So if you click on the ornaments and parks and stuff, you got all these cool different things you could add in the game onto your city, and it'll boost up your attractiveness. So for this one is my favorite. I love these fences, especially for the churches. So if I go ahead, lay down the end pieces here, flip these around. You can flip them around by pushing the comp or the period button or the two arrow keys. Make these all the way up here. I don't like building fences in blueprint mode. It takes a lot to upgrade them. Like for instance, if I go blueprint mode, and I lay this down, let's say I want to lay this down too, and you got a lot of different fence pieces and you want to upgrade all this, you could only upgrade one certain thing at a time. So you can only upgrade that one back wall at a time and then the corner pieces at a time. So it takes a lot of time, but I just build that up like that. So look at that, that looks pretty. I like that, that's nice and neat. And then there were some gaps up here that we need to fill up. So what we're going to do with those is find these nice trees I like in the new world, palm trees, and we're gonna click and drag and let go, and we are in blueprint mode again, darn it. So I'll upgrade that. Boom, look at that, looks a hell of a lot more better than just an empty space. Same thing around the fire station here, we gotta fill up that gap. It's not looking too hot over here. So what we could add is a little newspaper stand, why not? Everybody needs a good read once in a while. And then we'll add some little park benches. And they could grab their paper, sit on the benches, and read. Got more area to fill up over here. So it does cost money, so you gotta keep that in mind. So don't go crazy, too crazy, I would say. So we'll fill that up there. But we have lots of money, so we could spend it. We'll build some more houses. And then build some road around there. Oh, look at that. There we go. So we filled up a little bit here. We do have enough wood now, so we could go ahead and finish off our ponchos. So cattle farms, here we come. And then we're out of wood again. That's okay, we're making the cattle. I keep saying ponchos. I mean the tortillas. Darn it. Okay, and then another thing we could add to our little town that our new tier needs
we
is
could be better, I'm sure of it.
A boxing arena. So that's pretty cool. Neat new little building there. So let's go ahead, click on a nice little area for the boxing arena, and then we're gonna have to build a road around it. And then we're gonna decorate the crap out of it. So let's go like this. And then in the back stages here, we're going to put some nice gardens, some fountains. Can we fit those in there? No. We cannot, but we could do some benches. And then some nice bushes. There we go, that looks nice. And we'll just fence it off. Make it look like it's enclosed a little bit. There we go. There. So once we get enough wood for that, we need 20 wood. We'll speed up the game there. See how it works. Just like the fire station and the police station has, nothing's reaching up there, so that's a little worrying. But we'll add a fire station up here. That's the only thing I worry about the most, is these houses burning down. We'll add a fire station like that, and we'll add a road like that. Then we could add, I think, a few more houses up there if we have room. But okay, so what's our rum looking at? We're 146, that's awesome. We need more storage. Build that up, and then we'll check this out first. So there's our boxing arena. Brand new. Look at that. So full of detail. We got two entrances. Got people boxing away in there. Wrestling matches. Oh, gut shot. Oh. Buddy's just... Oh, my goodness. Just taking it all. What is that? A little jukebox thing playing music? That's awesome. And you see our residents are already hitting up the nice garden, the benches. Nice lady just sitting there. Nice. Everything's turning out good in the new world. Moving up. Quite rapidly.
Let them march. Let them egg the police.
Yes, yes, yes. Then what do we need? We need okay. Nope, we could build one more. There we go. Now we can make 225, and then we have to upgrade this too eventually. So I'm gonna let these resources build up like crazy, and then we're gonna go back to the old world before we finish off with this episode. Oh, we got a nice little quest here.
Any friend from this bright moon?
A very easy one. We just gotta take a picture. Take a photo of this chick's face. Oh. Very good. Submit photo. Continue. There we go. That was easy. We got something for that. Let's go ahead and decorate our new, our old world. So we got different ornaments. Comes with different tiers, so artisans we haven't unlocked yet, but we could unlock by building more artisans. Let's go ahead and do that. Why can I upgrade you guys?
Me around all you like.
Oh, the school's not close enough. That's weird. Oh well. So let's go ahead and upgrade you, and we'll upgrade you guys. We'll just do two. That drops down quite a bit. Then
you reached a new milestone.
There we go. So now we got different gardens and stuff that we could unlock and add to our marketplace and stuff. Let's go ahead, add some benches on the corners here. Why not?
These fabled lands exist.
And then we'll add some newspaper stands. We'll add one there, one there. Add some statues for some good luck. Maybe not any statues. But what we will add is some cool fountains. Maybe we'll add the newspaper right there. Go ahead, add these nice flowers for a nice entrance for the market area. Same with you, move you over. Like so. And what else do we have here? Oh yes, these nice fountains are awesome. We'll add them like this. And then we'll fill in the rest with some brick. So we'll
one
there. On there, we'll add a little statue there, why not? Turn you around a little bit. And then we'll do the same over here.
Changes, I hope.
There. Now we got a nice little detailed marketplace. Newspaper.
But you can't just... I mean, you can't leave it unedited.
We're going to make bank with that, too. Look at that. Back up to 1,700. It's
all
awesome.
Coming together now.
It kind of looks really shitty with those dirt roads, so we should build up our dirt roads with these brick roads. Make it look more satisfying. There we go. It's getting there. The same with the police station. We could add different things at the police station. I want to make it look like a garden area. Got nice trees here. We could add a few of those on the corners here. Nice trees. And anything with the new Bright Harvest? Not really. I just keep clicking on it, see what pops out. Oh, we could add some of these. These are pretty cool. Then you got flags and stuff. Anno, Union, look at that. There you go. That suits the police station. And then behind the station, we could add different trees and bushes. Go ahead, lay you down. And then we'll add shrubberies in between. There we go. And this is the bar, the pub. So we'll add some benches behind the pub so people could take their drinks and relax and get drunk as hell behind the pub. And then what else? We got our church. We'll do up later on when we unlock different fences. But yeah, so we decorated quite a bit there. We should have enough wood now in the new world to finish off what we wanted to do. Where we are. Okay, here we are. So here's our trading post. We'll upgrade that so we hold more resources. We are making ponchos.
Revolution bore fruit.
Ponchos, tortillas. We aren't making yet because we're waiting on wood to make the actual kitchens or the warehouse actually we need. So we'll add that. Add you.
No
and we
fields,
are missing.
No
oh, we didn't even add any 6 fields here. So that's a problem. So always make sure you're adding your fields. So there's no fields, so that thing's at a standstill. And it looks like we could add silos to these as well. So that's pretty cool. I wonder what they take up. Corn? Every time I highlight it, shows a corn. Oh, nice. So we could play around with that as well. Maybe we don't need this one. Maybe we just add corn. But yeah. So we hit off quite a bit, guys. Talking like crazy, speed talking, speed building. Well, this is how you get started in the new world. Turned out pretty good. We are minus 70 with that workforce, but we just need upgrade houses to fix that problem. So there we go. We did pretty good. So next episode, we'll start transporting all the rum back to the old world and start transporting goods and keep leveling up. Now, I think I'm going to cut this series short until we get to the next tier. Like, if you get this far in the game and you're making over 300,000, you have over 300,000 coins, you're making over 1,800, you're doing really good. You don't need any more help. But there is tips and tricks on the other tiers I could tap into later on. But I do want to get into another, back into the mods. So I'm going to probably hit that up, another series with that. So if you just want to watch me play with the mods and make the best of this game, hit that up and we'll see how far we can make it. But I'm Trigger08 and I hope you ladies and gents enjoyed this video. Hit the like button, share, leave some comments to let me know what you want to see in the near future for videos. And yeah, just let me know, hit me up. As always, have a good one, guys. Trigger08, signing off.